Hello all, welcome to the first supplementary dissection video in quite a while and our first video on osteology in a little while. This is Dr. Alsup, and in this video we will be discussing the osteology pertinent to the abdominal wall, peritoneum, and intestine session. Okay, so we have a lot of great things to see in this anterior view of the pelvic girdle. And what I mean when I say pelvic girdle is the two coxal bones or hip bones and the immovable portion of the vertebral column, the sacrum. And you can see a bit of the coccyx down here. So let's start with what we can see of the ilium, which is one of the three major parts of the hip bone. So this kind of from about here up is going to be a part of the ilium. It's going to be the superior, more fan-shaped portion of the bone. And now we have talked about the iliac crests before. Recall thinking about placing your hands on your hips. You are resting them on your iliac crest. So these are kind of the rim of the fan of the ilium. And the anterior most portion of this iliac crest is going to be what's referred to and has a very long name, the anterior superior iliac spine, or ASIS for short. You'll hear us refer to it quite a bit that way. And some of the abdominal muscles have an attachment here, as well as the inguinal ligament, or the floor of the inguinal canal. In fact, the inguinal ligament will extend from the ASIS all the way to the pubic tubercle, which is right here. So that's the pubic tubercle. You can see it really nicely over here as well. That's our next structure to locate. It's a fairly prominent bump for the area on the superior portion of the pubis bones or the pubic bones. So you can kind of, when you look at this line, that gives you an image of the general location of the inguinal canal. Now, while we're in the area of the pubic bone, let's talk about the one joint we are discussing in this section, which is the pubic symphysis, which is right here. It's a cartilaginous joint between the bodies of the pubis bones in the midline. Now, this is an important area as it is a joint, but it's also a general area for muscle attachment, and portions of the external genitalia also attach in this general region. All right, let's move back up to the more superior portions and discuss the pelvic inlet. The bony edge that surrounds and defines the pelvic inlet is the pelvic brim. But for our purposes, we're just going to collapse these terms as they are essentially meaning the same thing. So the pelvic inlet is the superior pelvic aperture. It's going to connect the sacral promontory, which is right here. And it's going to kind of move along this portion of the sacrum, follow along the ilium to the superior portions of the pubis, and it will make a kind of a complete circle here. And that is going to be the pelvic inlet or pelvic brim region. The brim is really going to divide between the greater pelvis, which is going to be up in this region, and the lesser pelvis, which is going to be more in this region, in this opening region right here. And we'll discuss that in a bit more detail in the reproductive anatomy session. And last but not least are the Ayla of the sacrum. And these are going to be these wing-like extensions kind of on either side of the sacral promontory. So important in terms of the superior lateral portions of the sacrum. Excellent. That should wrap us up in terms of the osteology we need to cover for this session. Please make sure to reach out if you have any questions, and I hope you have a great rest of your day.